Joining us on Hot Copy this morning, we have new Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel. Good morning to you, Senator Pimentel.
Magandang umaga, Karen, and to all of your viewers. Maayong buntag sa tanan na imbag nga bigat.
All right. Senator, President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. yesterday met with cabinet officials and actually tapped Attorney Harry Roque to discuss or be his counsel regarding the ICC issue on investigating the drug war in the Philippines. And while President Marcos has not yet spoken, Justice Secretary Remulla has given his personal opinion, saying they have no jurisdiction over us. What are your thoughts on this?
They have no jurisdiction over us as of the current time. Mm. But I think when we were a member, we committed that they would have jurisdiction during the period of time that we were, the Philippines was still a member of the ICC treaty. Mm. So yun po yun. And narinig ko rin naman that the attitude is to cooperate. If reports are needed, then the Philippine government will submit the requested reports. So that is a good start, Karen. Mm-mm. We should cooperate if you want to be treated as a responsible member of the international community. We have to comply with our treaty obligations.
Okay. But then, Senator Pimentel, do you agree with Secretary Remulla's statement saying we are investigating the issues on the drug war? Because the ICC said they've been asking the Philippines to comment on the ICC prosecutor because they claim the Philippines has failed to investigate. And Secretary Remulla disagreed with that. Are we investigating?
I've heard that before during the time of Secretary Guevara. He issued a statement that he would start the investigation. So, siguro technically speaking, we are investigating, but you know, the standards are different. Our standards here in the Philippines, due process means decades in court or decades being investigated. Maybe in other countries, they do not agree that due process equals decades in court or decades being investigated. So they're getting impatient, because if you are truly investigating, can you give us at least a partial report of your investigation?
Okay. Now, do you believe even if the Philippines is no longer a member of the ICC, they would still have some influence? Or, I mean, at least some global influence to do an investigation on their own?
But they should limit it to the time period when the Philippines was a member of the ICC. Mm-mm. Ganun po yun. Because ganun ang pagkaintindi ko, that tayo rin, we have to comply for as long as the relevant dates, the affected time period is within our membership with the ICC. Mm-mm.
Are you sensing that the present administration is protecting former President Duterte?
I am not sensing that yet. No, so let us wait for further pronouncements on the issue. Mm-mm. Because your pronouncement, ni Justice Secretary Remulla, he's reading off the treaty, our Mm-mm. obligation under the treaty. Mm-mm. Ako lang, meron lang ako medyo ibang interpretation that for the time period that we were a member of the ICC or a member of the treaty, we should comply.
Okay. Now, should the Philippines become a member again of the ICC, is it of value to us?
Yes, we should. The administration, the president being the chief architect of foreign policy, He should, I suggest that he reapplies for membership of the Philippines in the ICC. But parang court of last resort kasi ito eh. So that, you know, if there is suddenly, all of a sudden, an abuse occurring here in the Philippines, affecting life, liberty, human rights, maybe even property, and we cannot, and Filipinos could no longer run to the government or to the courts, then we have a court of last resort na matakbuhan po natin. Mm-mm. Available yan sa ibang citizens na ibang bansa who are members of the ICC. Sa atin, hindi na.
Mm-mm.
So, let us make this remedy available to our people. At any rate, hindi naman tayo ganun eh. Wala naman sigurong iahalal ang taong bayan na ilalagay sa pinakamakapangyarihang pwesto sa gobyerno para lang i-abuse sila o gipitin sila or abusuhin sila. So the culture tells us that we should not be producing such a leader. So there's nothing to fear with the membership in the ICC.
So there's nothing to fear in the membership of the ICC. What is the impact on President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. if under his administration we don't become members of the ICC?
Well, those who are pushing for the agenda of the ICC, which is yung mga the big crimes, big crimes against humanity, and there are countries which are pushing for this agenda, and there should be a world structure so that these great crimes against humanity can be prosecuted and the perpetrators brought to justice, they will be disappointed with the Republic of the Philippines. Magtataka din siguro sila, bakit kaya? There is no reason not to rejoin the ICC.
Now, President Marcos had that meeting, but in the State of the Nation address, he didn't talk about alleged human rights violations or the drug war. Were you disappointed with that, Senator?
I don't recall even the president talking about the justice system. So para sa akin, the matter of human rights is part of the justice system. So that is greatly disappointing, no? That no mention about the current state of our justice system, the speed or at which our courts are disposing of the disputes before them, di ba? Ang reklamo kasi is delay, justice denied, the quality of the decisions of our courts, and then yun na nga, human rights. How do we strengthen the protection of human rights in our country? Yung sa drug war, kung hindi po na-mention yun, at talaga naman hindi na-mention, that means na hindi na po niya yun priority. So correct naman na law enforcement will still be there, dealing in drugs would still be a crime, it should still be prosecuted, and the drug prevalence should be brought down, but ang priority ni President Marcos, this is loud and clear, is agriculture. Maybe the specific topic under agriculture would be increasing food production. That is the message I also get, and I agree with such a focus. But as we all know, we are not a one problem country. Marami tayong problema, but we also need to focus. And when you ask for a priority, you should know the meaning of the word priority. And ito yung uunahin ko. So yan po ang nakukuha nating message, agrikultura, hopefully meaning pagkain.
Okay. What do you think in general of the president's first SONA? Were you satisfied? Were you surprised?
Well, it was a safe SONA. When he got to the end of the SONA and he was enumerating, President Marcos was enumerating his legislative priorities, and I was taking down notes.
Yeah.
While taking down notes, I said to myself, I have heard all of this before. So sabi ko medyo, I think the president chose to be safe this time. No truly bold ideas. which I find surprising given his mandate. Somebody who got who allegedly got 31 million votes, which was 56 to 58% of the votes cast for president, has really an overwhelming mandate. So tawag po yata dyan, a political capital, which you could use to propose new bold ideas. And during his inauguration, Karen, I noticed, I recall that he used the phrase economic transformation. Hindi economic recovery, but transformation. Pero sa SONA, hindi po natin narinig yun.
Sorry to interrupt. You don't consider, Senator Pimentel, President Marcos Jr.'s condonation of farmers' loans that roughly amounts to something like 58 billion pesos. You don't consider that a bold move, at least in the SONA?
It's a good idea. I would support such a proposal. Pero tandaan po natin, ano na po kasi ito, these are parang accounts receivable. So, and accounts receivable from a sector which you would doubt if they really can afford the accounts receivable. So better for government accounting records just to condone, erase the write-off na po yan. And for the peace of mind of our agrarian reform beneficiaries that you are free from this burden na parati mong iniisip paano ko ito babayaran na sa tagal ng panahon, hindi ko nabayaran. So, i-free na natin sila doon. And then, pero ano pa rin, I mean, na-free sila from that worry, but then what is the positive act now that this time they are now capacitated now to till the land, plant, harvest, and contribute to the increase in food production. But that's a good idea.
Okay, but is there something that you wanted to hear specifically that was not discussed in the SONA?
Economic, yung using his own phrase, economic transformation. What's the meaning of that? So, wala, I did not hear that. Isa kanya rin ang galing yun. And then, this inflation, the fight against inflation. And then how will we solve our debt problem? Debt utang. Yung utang natin. Kasi I don't think we can go on forever borrowing. If our generation keeps on borrowing to support our lifestyle or the lifestyle that we want to live, so we are actually depriving our descendants of their own quality of living, quality of life.